Welcome, my friends, new ones, old ones, and whoever watches. I am going to color something today in Rooms of Wonder, and I found something that I thought would be really cute, and that is this little shower room in the forest. Who wouldn't want to take a shower there? Isn't that cute? So I thought today that's what we're going to do. We're going to use Prisma Colors pencils. I'm going to get my book open. We got a lot of greens again. And what I like to do is use my distressed ink because I think it adds a lot. I keep them all in my Kessel Art tin box. I have a little rice paper thing here that covered up Kessel Art, but it was just something to do. So what I like to do is take some green. We're going to start out with some Rustic Wilderness. I'm just going to take my little pad. It's just one of those spongy kind of things that you put your finger in. And I'm just going to not cover it all, because I'm coming back over this with my pencils. But it gives a different effect. Oh, I found a little frog down here. Just the leaves. And as you see, I'm not covering all of it. I'm just covering some of it. Let's see, this one is old paper. I don't know what that's gonna be like, but let's try it. A little different. Not much. We got a reprieve this week in the weather. Our temperatures have dropped in the low 80s. Right now it's in the 70s. Not supposed to get above 75. I mean 83. Okay. Let's move on over to the other side. I normally will shut the lid on these because it's hard to make sure you get the right lid on the right one. But this one is dark and light, so I can tell the difference. haven't made a video in a few days. Sometimes a little break is needed. I've been working on diamond art. I am also addicted now to that. I love it. But I like crafts, period. Anything creative. That's what I like to do. Okay, that's enough. There we go. Now I'm just gonna put it away. So, the next thing we're going to do is start working on our green. I'm going to pull some pencils. I have some short pencils that I'm trying to make sure that I get used up before I start my new batch. So they're little. What do we got here? Apple green. This one is lime peel. I know the thing is gone. Cerulean green. Spring green. Chartreuse. And Kelly green. Oops, we got two Kelly greens. I gotta use that one first. I don't go to a hobby store very often, so when I do, I've been grabbing pencils. So I have a whole little basket full of new pencils that I use the same color a lot with. But I keep wanting to use them instead of my little ones. So I've been putting them in a basket, see, and not today. Not until these are used up a little more. So we got, is this Kelly green? Apple green. And I'm just gonna hit or miss. I'm going to put these down. And what do we got here? Oh, this is the lemon peel. I'm just going to come back in and fill it in. These remind me of little stained glass windows up here. I printed off of Etsy a stained glass, I bought one of a little group of stained glass. And I enjoy doing that. I don't have it close at my desk or I would show you. There's something about coloring that just relaxes me more. Than anything else I do. I'm crocheting, I'm making a kind of a vest thing out of what do they call it? Multicolored, where the yarn just keeps changing colors. This is a, I think it's a six-sided, or maybe it's more, six-sided granny square. And you just keep going, and then you fold it from one corner to the other. I need my little... This really helps. These are pencil guards. I just don't like using those pencil extenders because every time you need to sharpen it, you have to take it off and put it back. So I find these work really nice. They protect your hand from that corner. You get a whole bunch of them on Amazon for under $5 or somewhere in there. And then I just cut them in half. The reason I started cutting them in half is because they don't fit over my Polychromos pencils, because Polychromos is so much fatter. And I had to really work on that. So this one doesn't fit right there yet, so it's still okay. But once it fits down in that little part of your hand, it really pokes. You know, when I first started doing all of this, I listened to every person and over trying to learn what I should and shouldn't do. And now that I've been doing this for a while, I pretty much threw it all out and said, I'm going to do what I want to do. And I find a lot of people do the same thing. So if you're new, it's good to watch people and listen. But eventually, after you do this for a while, you're going to throw a lot of stuff out and say, this is the way I want to do it. And a lot of people won't like it. But you do it how you want to do it. The whole thing is, you do it because you love it. And you do it just for the enjoyment of it. And once you start losing your peace about it, you're not going to have fun. I took a little break and I thought about it. And I'm just going to enjoy it. I'm not going to worry about what other people think or say. Not saying I know everything, and I don't. I just want to enjoy it. and those who love me and follow along with me. We're just doing this because we love it. And I love your company. See, I'm just kind of hitting and missing. That's what I'm doing. And look at how cute it looks. I think a lot of mine, as I've said before, my coloring style comes from my toll painting and watercoloring and all the things I have tried doing. And there are some amazing colorists. And then there's a few that, well, I'm not gonna go there. All I'm gonna say is just enjoy it. It's a cool day, it's been really hot. I've had to have this air conditioner on and it's really loud. If you don't see me sometimes, it's just because it's hard to get it all together and be able to make a video just like I do in the winter time. I think we're gonna go with our cerulean. Green on these little guys. But you see how I'm just going over it? It just because I put that green down doesn't mean anything. But it does help. Because I color so many green pictures. Everything has got leaves and those are the books that I'm kind of drawn to. I think I've got all but one of Joanna's books, and they're all lots of green. Well, this is Joanna's book. I think it's Rooms of Wonder. Yeah. In case I didn't say that, I don't remember now. And of course, you don't have to do any of the distressed ink. Just color. I don't know why, I just find it makes it a little bit easier. looks pretty. You could come back in here with a darker color and shade it a little bit if you want. Which it does make a difference. So what would be darker? Let's try a little Kelly green. I don't know if that's going to show up. Yeah. It does make a big difference. I wonder if I should put you guys down a little bit. If you can see better. I know sometimes when it's too high, you don't see the colors very good. I'm just going right at the bottom, giving it a little and this one's ready to, for a little put it on the other side, it's more smoother. Whenever I do these in the morning, I forget to eat breakfast. And then I'm sitting here hungry. Let me do that one. You can see what a difference it makes. And you don't have to do this, and it'll still be pretty. This just gives it just a little more dimension. Sometimes I get lazy, I know. I didn't realize I had this. I saw it colored. I thought that's so cute. Little shower. There we go. All right, so we can do these little leaves. I used to be so worried when I first got my pencils. I don't want to use them all up. I know that's silly. But you know, Prisma's the ones I keep replacing, so I've replaced a few polychromos, but Prisma's really what I like. And depending on the paper, Castle Art works very well too. Alright, so this is apple green, so let's try that. Better sharpen it just a little bit. Get down in there. You gotta have enough contrast where there's just a little bit of contrast. You can tell more on the bigger leaves than you can the little leaves. But it still gives a very pretty effect. We got a little key hanging in the tree over here. Did I get them all? I think we got them all. So now, okay, I need we'll try some artichoke on this branch. Then we'll come in with just a little bit darker. Have those plants that are called string of pearls. I have two of them, one little one and one bigger one. They remind me of that. I saw a grocery store in a little tiny town, you know, those old grocery stores with the wooden floors and they're a little bit dusty inside. They had a big one hanging from a pie growing down low, and I always loved that plant. I thought, someday I'm going to have me one of them. But I didn't know what that was. I always loved plants. Sometimes I get too many. I think we'll do this one on this side too while we're here. Okay, so I need something a little darker. To shade that in, I think. Let's see what this is. Moss green. Let's try it. I think that will work. Just do some of the little knobby things, the beginning and the end. Okay. You can see the difference between this one and that one. It just adds a little more depth. That little birdie sitting up there. He's the only little birdie we got. I'm not sure what this is here. I think it's like a wall. I think that's what it is. I think that's good enough. Okay. So, let's do these little leaves. Oh, there's a little snail. Let me sharpen that just a little bit. Oh, there's a little butterfly. We got a few pretty flowers. There's the chartreuse. Doing that one. Okay. I've got to erase this one little spot. Okay. Wonder what color we should make our little flowers. Well, I'm still thinking. Those are too close. Lilac and pomace green. There we go. Gray lavender. I think we'll do these two. And what color should we make the center? Yellow okra. I think that will be good. And then we'll just we got a couple down here. And we'll take our gotta get something a little darker. Okay, sandbar brown. That works pretty good. Now That dog has been barking and barking and barking for a few days already. And there's nothing to bark at. It's my neighbor's dog, not mine. Okay. So we're just doing the center with the lavender. It's gray lavender, actually. And doing the outside with the pump. Violet. Parma. Violet. There we go. How about this little butterfly? Let's make him the same color. We got our little snail. We need kind of a fleshy color for his body, like peach. These are walls coming down, so we're going to have to work on that. All right, so we got our little ones over here. There we go. And got two more on the bottom. That's a pretty soft color, isn't it? Oops, there comes the pencils. Just going right over everything and just blending it together. That's the way I like to do it. Okay, I think brighten those up a little bit. These are okay. I didn't go over that. Okay. Now we've got this little bird. What are we gonna do with him? We're gonna put some pomegranate red on him to start with. Might as well make him stand up. I'm going to make his little face yellow. And put some yellow right in here. We're going to have to do something with his beak. Beige sienna. Start with going over his beak. He's got one little toe there. That's okay. And then we need a little darker. Let's try some French Gray 70. Okay. Now, let's find a teal. Color half his eye. Leave a little spot right there. Let's try that. And true green. I don't like that. I don't like that at all. And so take off the top layer. It's not all going to come off, but we can get the top layer off. Maybe we'll put the yellow in here. Maybe down here. He's got character. The chartreuse green. Okay. So now I need that's too little. Okay, that worked. And a black. it's just kind of taking it right back off. Oh well. Well, he didn't quite turn out the way I would want him, but it's okay. Right, so I'm going to move these colors up and out of the way. And what do we got? Kelly Green. Gonna pull it down. Like that. What is this one? This one is moss green. I'm just gonna do the stem in the middle. Like that. Whoops. Okay. Oh, I see. miss some of that in there. These are pretty cool leaves. I like these. Kind of pushing that color out. Okay. Oops, we missed one right here. Excuse me. that's making some pretty leaves. Just pushing the color out and then coloring the ends. And we get all those. Now we got some over here. Let's do those. Okay, bird of paradise. I don't want to. I don't know what color they are. I'm not going to look it up. I know they're orange and purples. Apple green. I'm sure this isn't the way they're supposed to look. So if you know exactly, color them exactly. Okay, so now we're back to these two. I was thinking I used the Kelly green. Yeah, I think I did. Oops. Okay, we've got one more little guy up here. Okay. Do these in the moss green, whatever these little guys are poking out behind here. Our little frog is making these are kind of like palm leaves, I guess. Okay, I think I'm going to switch to my cerulean green. And now I'm just going to do the outside of these. Inside's already colored. Gonna switch to apple green. Must be the key to the shower. Oops, I don't want to use that one. Go back to the lavender. Okay, so now we need some rock color. Okay. So this is 30% cool gray. Going to use 50% warm gray. Okay, we need some light blue. I think this is supposed to be soapy water down here. Green leaves right here. All right, I need my pencil sharpener. Gotta use the right side. Won't fit in that hole. Just gotta get some of that. Is this powder blue or is this sky blue? Sky blue. Okay, I just want a little darker blue. Maybe that one's too dark. Let's try photo, non-photo. I just want to do the very bottom. Kind of hard to do just those little teeny. Okay, so now we're just going to do our little faucet up here. I'm going to do a light gray. Like that. Then let's take our dark gray. I'm just going to take my light gray and just blend that a little bit more. Okay. I like that so far. This is my moss green. Just doing the edges. And then I'm going to use my Kelly green. And just kind of blending it. And I'm going to take my white. And I'm just blending it all together. Is this apple? Yeah. I could have left them the way they were. I'm just kind of playing around. See what I can create. Just mixing colors together. Okay, let's do these two down here. I may end up using all of this little pencil. And over the top with apple green. Gotta experiment if you're gonna figure out different ways of doing it. I do like it. Oops. I forget you can use the side of your pencil to cover more ground. I forgot this little guy. Oh, the different colors underneath it make it unusual. Okay. I think I'll use the moss green around this little like that. It turned out pretty cute. Well, I thank you all for watching. I appreciate that you spend your time with me. And if nobody's told you you're awesome and amazing and wonderful today, I'm telling you, I think you are. You're such wonderful people. I just have the best followers in the world. You guys are all amazing, amazing, totally amazing. Can I get you closer? See if you can see the colors a little better. I think it turned out really cute. I love it. Let me raise you up a little bit so you can see the whole thing. There you go. Maybe we'll have to do the next page next. That's looking pretty cool. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing. If you like it, please give me a thumbs up. It just helps other people find me. And let me know that you like it. And share. So, till the next time. Bye.